confused or unsure about where to live in London, then make sure to watch this video to find out about the hottest neighbourhoods in London for expats. Hi everyone, Ugo Arinzeh here with Onyx Property Consultants and Keller Williams. If you're new to my YouTube channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell because I put out weekly content on the London property market and all the things you're going to need in living in this fabulous city. Having moved over from America myself, I specialize in working with expats and international families to help them find their perfect home. In this video, I'm going to talk about the three top neighborhoods that expats really love to live in and why you might want to consider them. Make sure to watch to the end as I have a free special offer just for you. First up is Notting Hill. This neighborhood was made super popular by the 1999 movie starring Julia Roberts and Hugh Grant. One of the most famous scenes in the movie is when they sneak into that private garden in the middle of the night. Now make sure you don't try to sneak into one of these private gardens because they are for the exclusive use of for the homes that border the gardens, which is one of the things that makes Notting Hill so special are these private garden squares where only the residents along the square can access. They'll have a special key to use it. Some of the parks and the squares will have all different sizes. Some might even include private tennis courts. Its most popular destination is the Portobello Market and Portobello Road, where you find fantastic antiques and all different kind of vendors selling all different kinds of things, and the shops that go along that street are really particularly cute and charming as well. Notting Hill is also really popular for its central location, the beautiful homes, and the private garden squares that I've mentioned. Notting Hill also has some incredible pastel colored houses and muse properties that really make it so distinct. So while you've got the white stucco fronted options, you've got some beautiful streets with these pastel colored homes. As you stroll along streets like Chepstow Villas, Clarendon Road, and Portobello Road, you will come across these beautiful, enchanting pastel-colored homes that makes Notting Hill so special. You've also got these white stucco-fronted Victorian mansions or homes, and some of them have been converted into flats. Walk along Ladbroke Gardens and Kensington Gardens to see some of the most beautiful homes, as well as the gardens and parks that make this area really one of the top places to live. Notting Hill is also incredibly famous for its fantastic dining and restaurant options. From the upscale and chic Core by Claire Smith, she's a former Gordon Ramsay chef patron, to the Electric Diner, which serves up American-style hamburgers, hot dogs, milkshakes, and other things you're gonna love. For green space, you're gonna have Kensington Gardens and Holland Park nearby. Next up is South Kensington. This area is popular not just with Americans, but the wealthy throughout the world. It's a very upscale part of London, located in Southwest London, just south of Hyde Park. South Kensington borders Chelsea, Knightsbridge, and Belgravia, some of London's most upscale areas. When you think of the white stucco-fronted homes, add in high-end retailers, fantastic restaurants, and incredible culture, you're probably thinking about South Kensington. Some of South Kensington's most popular restaurants include Daphne's on Draycott Avenue, Blake's Restaurant on Roland Gardens, and Cloud Bossy at Bibendum at Michelin House on Fulham Road. The cultural institutions of South Kensington make it absolutely unrivaled. You've got some of the world's top destinations for museums, arts, and culture. You have the V&A Museum, the Natural History Museum, and the Science Museum just along Exhibition Road. In addition, you've got Royal Albert Hall on the edge of Hyde Park. You also have the prestigious Imperial College, one of the world's top research universities, located in South Kensington. In addition, Richmond, the American International School in London, has a Kensington campus. So have you been to Notting Hill or South Kensington? What are your thoughts on those neighborhoods? Make sure to leave me a comment below. Shifting locations, we are going northwest to St. John's Wood. St. John's Wood is truly a wonderful neighborhood because it's got this wonderful village vibe, great transport links, and fantastic schools. Most notable, the American School in London is located in St. John's Wood, so it's very popular with American expats. But once you arrive there, you'll quickly discover all the extra things that makes this area so desirable. As I mentioned, St. John's Wood has a great village feel, and it has some of the most stately homes in London. You've got Hamilton Terrace, which is one of London's most expensive streets, with these gorgeous, large villa-style homes. But you've also got some fantastic purpose-built buildings, such as St. Edmund's Terrace, providing all the concierge and high-end amenity services that you'll need. You also have various purpose-built blocks and apartments and flats throughout St. John's Wood. With its Zone 2 location located on the Jubilee Line, St. John's Wood is highly popular for banking executives and other corporate executives because you can easily get into stops such as Mayfair, Westminster, as well as Canary Wharf, all on the Jubilee Line. As I keep mentioning, St. John's Wood really has a very villagey feel, and the High Road has a wonderful mix of high-end as well as mid-price shops and restaurants. Some of St. John's Wood's most popular restaurants includes the Duke of York Pub, the Ivy, and Oslo Court. On a previous video, I also mentioned there's wonderful Panzer's Deli, which is very popular with Americans because it has a great selection of American foods as well as other food items. So you definitely want to check out Panzer's. I'll put the link in the description below. For green space, St. John's Wood is located just next to Primrose Hill and Regents Park, and the views from Primrose Hill can be quite stunning. There's also Lord's Cricket Grounds, home of cricket, as well as Abbey Road Studios, where the Beatles recorded some of their best hits. That zebra crossing still exists and is a popular tourist destination spot to take pictures. So if you want to know more about London, make sure to check out my free relocation guide. I'll put the link below, and you can also download it off my channel banner on my homepage. So what do you think of the areas have I mentioned? Are there other areas of London that you want to know more about? Make sure to comment, let me know, so I can create the videos that you want to watch. In the meantime, you can check out my other videos about the London property market, where to live in London, where to find some of your favorite American foods, and other things you're going to want to watch as you discover more about London. So that's Ugo Arinzeh with Onyx Property Consultants and Keller Williams. Bye for now.